A very good morning, friends. Today's topic of discussion is isoenzyme. This is one of the important questions in biochemistry. You may get a short note or LAQ on this topic. We'll discuss this topic under the heading of definition, then how these isoenzymes are formed, how they are formed. Then third point is some characteristics. An example with clinical significance. Under these headings, we'll discuss isoenzyme. Coming to the definition, isoenzymes, they are different forms, of same enzyme catalyzing the same reaction. So there are different forms of same enzyme catalyzing the same reaction. Take one example, lactate dehydrogenase. There are various isoenzymes of lactate dehydrogenase, that is LDH1, LDH2, LDH3, LDH4 and LDH5. Each lactate dehydrogenase, either it is 1, 2 or 3 or 4 or 5, it catalyzes conversion of lactate into pyruvate. NAD is required as a coenzyme. It is converted into NADH. So these are the different variants, or these are the different isoenzymes of lactate dehydrogenase catalyzes the same reaction, that is conversion of lactate into pyruvate. But they differ with some properties. For example, they differ in electrophoretic mobility. That's why they are known as isoenzymes. Now coming to the next, that is how they are formed. This is somewhat difficult to remember how they are formed. The one trick is there, or one mnemonic is there to remember how they are formed. It is true lady is allowed. This is the mnemonic. True means true isoenzymes are isozymes. Lady means lactate dehydrogenase. Is means isoforms. And allowed, the meaning is alloenzyme or allozymes. So these are the four terms which are important in the formation. The first one is true isoenzymes, when they are originated from the different genes. They are known as true isoenzymes. They are originated from different genes, and these genes may be present on different chromosomes. The example is amylase. It has two forms, that is pancreatic amylase and salivary amylase. So it is an example of isoenzyme originated from different gene and located on different chromosome. So this is the first. Then second is the lactate dehydrogenase. There are 5 isoenzymes of lactate dehydrogenase, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. And all isoenzymes or all variants, they are present in same individual. And it is present in all individual of population. So all variants, they are present in same individual and it is present in all individuals of the population. Third one is the isoforms, means they are produced due to the post-translational modification. In the protein. The example is alkaline phosphatase. There are various isoenzymes of alkaline phosphatase. It is due to the salicylic acid content or carbohydrate content in the alkaline phosphatase. There are 6 isoenzymes of alkaline phosphatase. It is due to the post-translational modification in the protein. Then alloenzymes, they are originated from the different alleles of same gene, or different, they are originated from different alleles of same locus of the gene. So they are known as alloenzyme. Example is glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase. There are near about 400 isoenzymes of glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase. And only one variant is present in one individual. So one variant, it is present in one individual. So this is how they are formed. From the different genes, from the different alleles, by the post-translational modification, and they are present, some isoenzymes, all isoform of that enzymes, they are present in the same individual. So this is how they are formed. Now coming to the some characteristics of isoenzymes. The first one is electrophoretic mobility. Isoenzyme catalyzes the same reaction, but at some properties they are different. The first one is the electrophoretic mobility. For example, LDH1 moves fast in electrophoresis as compared to LDH5. This is the slowest moving component. This is fastest. Then CK, there are 3 isoforms, 1, 2 and 3, and alkaline phosphatase. These enzymes can be separated by electrophoresis. Then second, some enzymes, they are heat labile, means stability to heat. The hepatic variant or alpha 2 heat labile variant, which is present in liver, it is sensitive to the heat. Then third, various inhibitors. Example is tartrate labile acid phosphatase. Then fourth, cofactors. Different isoenzyme requires different cofactor. For example, isocitrate dehydrogenase, the mitochondrial variant, it requires NAD as a cofactor, while cytosolic variant, it requires NADP as a coenzyme. So first one is the electrophoretic mobility. then stability to the heat, then sensitive to the inhibitor or inhibition by the inhibitors, then different cofactor requires for the different isoenzymes, then fifth point, sensitive to antibodies, it is different isoenzymes are sensitive to different antibodies, and sixth one is the tissue of origin. Tissue of origin. For example, there are six isoenzymes of alkaline phosphatase, bone, liver, intestine, biliary, then placental and leukocyte alkaline phosphatase. So these are the six from the tissue of origin. So these are the some characteristics in which they differ from each other. Electrophoretic mobility, stability to the heat, sensitivity or inhibition by inhibitor, different cofactors required for the different isoenzymes, sensitivity to antibody and their tissue of origin. Now coming to the examples, there are three classical examples of isoenzymes. The first one is the LDH, second one is the creatine phosphokinase or creatine kinase, and third one is the alkaline phosphatase. Now coming to the one by one and their diagnostic utility, the first one is the LDH. There are five isoenzymes, that is LDH 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. It is a tetramer composed of H and M unit. LDH 1, it is made up of all H, it is 3H and 1M, it is H2M2, HM3 and M4. These are the subunit in LDH 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. This H4 variant, it is present mainly in the heart, while this H4 it is in liver and M4 it is in muscle. In normal condition, concentration of LDH2, it is 35% of the total LDH activity. Means it is in highest concentration, LDH2. And followed by the LDH1, that is near about 27%. But in myocardial infarction, the concentration of LDH1 increases as compared to LDH2. That is known as flipped pattern. Flipped pattern of LDH. This component, that is LDH1, is the fastest moving in electrophoresis, while this is slowest. M4 is the slowest moving component. This one is the LDH1 is the specific marker for myocardial infarction, but it is a late marker. Means it started rising after the attack, 6 to 12 hours after the attack, reaches at its peak in 24 to 48 hours and return to the normal in 6 to 10 days, 6 to 8 days or 6 to 10 days, it comes to the normal. So this is LDH. Now coming to the isoenzymes of creatine kinase or creatine phosphokinase. This creatine is converted into phosphocreatine with the help of creatine kinase. There are three isoenzymes, CK1, 2 and 3. It is a dimer composed of M and B unit. CK1, it is composed of BB. This is MB and this is MM. It is a dimer composed of 2 unit. The concentration of BB, it is increases in brain infarction or brain diseases. It is specific to the heart, CKMB. and it is earliest enzyme marker in myocardial infarction. Earliest and enzymatic marker in myocardial infarction. It started rising in 3 to 6 hours after the attack, reaches peak in 12 to 18 hours and come back to the normal in 24 to 36 hours. So it is important in the diagnosis of myocardial infarction. And MM, it is increases in muscle disorders or muscular dystrophies. So this is about CK. They catalyzes the same reaction, but they differ in electrophoretic mobility, also their component, also their tissue of origin. Now coming to the third and important one, that is alkaline phosphatase. There are six main isoenzymes of alkaline phosphatase. That is alkaline phosphatase. There are six isoenzymes of alkaline phosphatase depending upon their carbohydrate content and source of any origin. The first one is the, that is on the basis of their electrophoretic mobility, they are classified as alpha 1, alpha 2 heat labile, alpha 2 heat stable, then pre beta, gamma and leukocyte alkaline phosphatase. So these are the six isoenzymes of alkaline phosphatase. Now this alpha 1, it is present in biliary tree and constitute about 10% of total activity. This heat labile, it is in liver, constitute about 25% of total activity of alkaline phosphatase. Then this is placental variant, placental origin. Then pre-beta, it is from the bone and it constitutes about 50% of total alkaline phosphatase activity. Gamma, it is present in intestine. And this is in the leukocyte. So these are the six isoenzymes of alkaline phosphatase. Now, the clinical importance of alkaline phosphatase is very increased activity of alkaline phosphatase near about 2 to 3 times of the normal. The normal range varies according to the kit. It is 30 to 300 international unit per liter. Slightly higher levels are found in children or growing age. Increase in alkaline phosphatase activity 2 to 3 times of the normal, it is seen in hepatic diseases, that is viral hepatitis. Then increase in ALP level 10 to 12 times of the normal, it is seen in obstructive pathology, means obstructive jaundice and intrahepatic cholestasis. There is increase in 10 to 10 times of the normal. This is because ALP, it is an ectoenzyme, it is present on the surface of biliary canaliculi. And whenever there is obstruction, there is irritation of epithelial cells of biliary canaliculi. Due to the back pressure and continuous irritation, and as it is an ectoenzyme, there is release of ALP into a serum. So this is our secretion of ALP. And that causes increased ALP level in the blood. Then third, there is increase up to 25 times of the normal. It is in bone diseases. So this is clinical significance of alkaline phosphatase. So this is all about isoenzyme. So keep watching. Thank you.